Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. Now this is the Steel 026 chainsaw, a professional chainsaw that I have for more than 20 years. Now I bought it already second hand from a professional user, so this chainsaw really did a lot of work up to now. And whenever I do anything with a chainsaw, this one is always with me. Why? Because it's very strong, but also very light. So you can really use it for doing a lot of work, felling trees, cutting branches, working above your head, doing some maintenance, making firewood. So this is my really favorite saw. Now this saw is a professional saw for the light and medium type of work. In the past I also used it for some heavy work, but that's also why the piston got jammed, because it got overheated. And that's exactly why I bought also a stronger saw to do the heavy work. And that is why for the heavy work I bought this chainsaw, the MS362. This is also a professional chainsaw, but this is for the heavier forestry type of work. This one I use for felling larger trees and thicker logging, things like that. But because of the difference in weight, I like to go back to the 026 for the smaller stuff. So what you typically see is that I do about 20 to 30% with this one, but all the other stuff, 70 to 80%, I do with the old 026. And because it's already getting old and I had to repair it already a couple of times, you can also see some examples of that on my channel. And because I use it that much and I really don't want to miss it during my forestry work, I also decided to look at the successor of the 026. And that is this one, the MS261CM. So this is the successor of the old 026. This is also a professional chainsaw. I still change from 026 to 261. So let's now look together at the features of this chainsaw and compare it with the old 026. And while doing so, I will also take into account the MS362 as well. Now this difference already starts with the chain. Now both have an 0.325 inch chain pitch, and you can still use your old file, no problem there. But still they're different, because Steel developed the Rapid Super Pro chain for the MS26, which is much thinner than the old 0.325 inch chains. And that's what we see over here. So the thickness of the links of the Rapid Super Pro is 1.3 millimeter versus 1.6 of the old version. And here you see the three chains in close-up, where you can really see the difference, where the thicker 3/8 chain of the MS362, the 3/25 chain on the old 026, and the much thinner Rapid Super Pro chain on the new MS261. Now these are all pro chainsaws, which you can already tell by the metal cover at the chain sprocket. Now on the old 026, as well as on the MS362, which is also already a few years old, you see the typical switch of Steel with off, choke, full throttle, on and off. Now with the M-tronic, the switch has changed. This is the on position. When you want to start the system, you can put it at start. Doesn't matter whether it's warm or cold, it will always give the optimal gasoline air mixture. After starting, you can use the throttle to set it in on position, and then you can use the chainsaw. And when you want to stop it, you put it in stop position and the engine will switch off. Releasing the switch, it will automatically go back into on position. Now when the saw has been used for a while and the engine is warm, you can also start it at this position, but you can also use the start position, because it doesn't matter whether it's warm or cold, it will always have the optimal setting for starting the engine. And that has to do with the M-tronic feature of this system. And that's also where the M comes from in the name 261CM, because these old systems still have the three well-known screws, high, low, and the idle adjustment. And here you see there are no screws. There's nothing to adjust. So this system is auto-adjusting it using an electronic control. So fiddling around with carburetor adjustment is history on this machine. It always chooses the optimum performance. And that of course is great, because also When, for example, the air filter is getting a little bit more clogged, then it automatically adapts to its optimal setting. And that is not only giving an optimal performance in strength, but it will also save fuel. So that's a great thing. Now another great thing is that losing the bolts is history with the new concept, because they are sticking into the cover. So you can never lose them and always put it back. So you don't have to worry about losing a chain nut on this machine, because it cannot happen. So let's also have a look under the hood. Now to remove the hood, you have to release these three screws. They're bayonet type of screws. So one click is enough, and then you can remove it. And here you see the system with the long life air filter and the electronics on the carburetor for the M-tronic. With the MS-362, the same type of closure. And the Alt 026 has a different type of closure, where for the air filter you had to remove this cover, and without any tool you can then check and clean the air filter. And to remove the top part, you need to release the nut. There we go. So the general principle of the system is still the same. Air filter, carburetor and cylinder and muffler. But on the other hand, you also see a lot of difference. Completely different air filter. This is long life. And the electronics on the carburetor to have the optimal performance. Now we can all look in the catalog and find the weight of these systems in an empty state and without bar and chain, but you never use it that way. So I'm going to do a weight measurement with a bar, with chain, and completely filled up with oil and fuel, and then do a comparison. Now, the MS-261 and the MS-362 both have a chain and bar of 40 centimeter or 16 inch, and the old 026 has a bar of 35 centimeter or 14 inch. Now for these measurements I will use this Steinberg scale. It has both a resolution and an accuracy of 0.1 kilo. So let's now create our specialized chainsaw weight measurement setup. Now the old 026 is the oldest chainsaw with the most operating hours on it, so I think purely out of respect we should start with the old 026 as a first measurement. So let's see what it weighs. ...6.6 kilos. Is it still zero? It's still zero. Well, to keep it exciting, I will now take the MS-362 for weight measurement. So the complete MS-362 weighs 7.9 kilos. And now it becomes really exciting. Now we're going to put on the new machine. ...6.4 kilos. Now it's very interesting to see that the new successor, completely filled up with chain and bar, is even lighter than the old 026. And why is that so interesting? It is because the empty specification of the weight, this one is lighter. 4.7 kilos versus 4.9 kilos. So I expected, to be honest, that this one would be at least the same or even a little bit heavier. Also because the fuel tank is 0.46 versus 0.5 liter, so it also has a bigger fuel tank. The oil tank, however, 0.29, 0.27, is a little bit smaller on this one. So it has more fuel, a little bit less oil, but it also weighs more in an empty state, and it has a longer bar than that one. But of course, the chain is also much lighter because of it's much thinner. Well, in the end, it results in a lighter weight. So let's also look at the cylinder volume. 48.7, 50.2, 59 cubic centimeter. So let's also look at the power performance. 2.4 kilowatt, 3 kilowatt, 3.4. So this one is indeed stronger than that one, but is also heavier. And now comes the interesting one. So let's now also look at the specific power performance. So the kilowatts per weight. And then we see 0.36 kilowatt per kilogram, 0.47 kilowatt per kilogram, 0.43 kilowatt per kilogram. So when you look at both systems in an empty state, like you see in the catalog, they both have 0.61 kilowatt per kilogram specific power. But when you fill them up and you have the chain and everything mounted, then you see that this one is having a higher specific performance than that one. Now, I was already very enthusiastic about this saw because it's the successor of Grandpa over here, which already did a lot of work. I'm still proud of that saw, by the way. But now I'm even more enthusiastic because that means that this is a very strong but light saw. And together with the new chain, which is thinner and as a result will also cut faster through wood, I'm very, very curious what the experience will be. So enough talking, let's go outside and do some actual chainsaw cutting. So, in the start position. And you see it automatically goes back. And if correct, I should now also be able to start it. So let's check the thickness in cuts. 026, 7.1, MS261, 6.4, MS362, 7.4. Now it's great to work with these professional saws. Grandpa over here, the old 026, still a good saw, does what it has to do. Not as strong as it used to be anymore, like a real grandpa, but it's still a very good saw and it does what it has to do in the light and medium type of work. The MS362, this is an aggressive beast. It's really strong and it really attacks the wood. You can really feel it coming in. And it's really for the heavy stuff. And now the new guy on the block, the MS261. This is again my new favorite. It's a very strong saw, it's a light saw, but also it runs very, very smooth. The new chain is great. This chainsaw goes into wood like a hot knife into butter. This is a real great saw. As I mentioned in the beginning, with the 026, it was typically like 70-80%. I think this percentage will go up because this is also a very strong saw, so it will also be able to do thicker parts as well. The start system works great. On the other hand, I never had any problems with the old system with the separate choke, but it works great. I also really like the M-tronic, so you always have the optimal performance and the optimal running of your chainsaw. Also, when something changes in temperature, in elevation, in air pressure, in clogging of filter, it will automatically adapt the optimal gasoline and air mixture. So I'm also very curious how that will evolve in time. We'll see. There's a long life air filter, and also the M-tronic automatically adapts to the clogging of your filter, so you can run very long without having to clean your filter. The decompression knob I don't use. I start it always without, but if you prefer, you can also use that. This also has this quick release caps. In the MS362, they'll already start leaking relatively fast, so I hope that will not be the case in this time, but we'll see. So I'm looking forward to do some foresting work with it, cutting high branches, felling down trees, making firewood, things like that. I'm really going to enjoy this one, I'm very sure. Of course, I will also use the other ones, but this will be my favorite. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and I see you next time.